Hey, Teresa, build a Mac Pro Killer Hackintosh. What about the Apple 2019 Mac Pro Killer Hackintosh? Teresa, why don't you build a new 2019 Mac Pro Hackintosh? So these questions I'm getting quite often. So let's dive into it. Hi, I'm Teresa from morgonow.cloud and I provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and server builds. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button below and hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. Right on the beginning, I wanna say, after you will watch this whole video, you will have better overview of whole problematics and I wanna know your personal opinion. So below this video in comments section, I will be waiting for your ideas and your point of view. I will closely watch all your comments and based on those, I will build a monster machine which could fulfill at least some of your expectations. So now let's go to the hardcore part. 2019 Apple Mac Pro can have dozens of configurations, from the super duper over $50,000 one down to just less under $6,000. The real question is, what do you personally expect when you ask me to build a 2019 Mac Pro Killer Hackintosh? Do you mean in CPU performance? In GPU performance? In what tasks you wanna beat the 2019 Mac Pro? That's really very important to mention, because if you would just want to massage your ego in Hackintosh forums by saying I have faster Hackintosh than new Mac Pro for just a third of a price is simply not a valid argument. To build a Hackintosh which would have higher CPU performance is quite easy, and even my 14-core iMac Pro Killer Hackintosh build would be faster than the base 8-core new 2019 Mac Pro. And that's again important. Can you see I said would be faster than the base 8-core Mac Pro? But what about to beat the 28-core Mac Pro model? Huh? Now the problem starts. I'm now not talking about some leak of small home computers, but about high-end super powerful Hackintosh built in 2020. Latest AMD Threadrippers, the 3960X, 3970X and 3990X, you simply cannot use for Hackintosh. You will fail. It's simply not supported. Period. Finito. Schluss. No way around it. Only possibility how to get on par with the 28-core Mac Pro is to build it on server-grade hardware like the Supermicro X11 SPH-T motherboard and install the same CPU to it as is used in 2019 Mac Pro. But then your Hackintosh would cost even more than the Mac Pro. Do your own research and you would come to the same conclusion. So, you cannot build a Hackintosh which would beat the 28-core Mac Pro in CPU performance under macOS for less money. If you would run Linux, then yes, but Hackintosh is about to run macOS on ordinary PC hardware. Also, you should never forget about why is macOS, or better say Mac computers overall, so good. Even with 8, 12, 16 cores in Mac Pro, you can beat 32-core Threadripper 3970X running Windows or Linux in some tasks. So here core count is not comparable. It showed nicely, for example, Snazy Labs in his video last week, I think. It's simply not just about CPU core count, but about the overall performance when running some task. And that brings me to second chapter, and that is GPU performance. Only 2019 Mac Pro can accommodate currently most powerful GPU on planet, the Radeon Pro Vega 2 Duo GPU MPX module with an FP32 performance of 28.3 teraflops with two GPUs, each with 32 GB of VRAM on a single card. And again, only in the 2019 Mac Pro you can even run two of these monster cards, so two dual GPUs with in total 128 GB of video memory. So how you wanna beat that by building a Hackintosh? Impossible. You can build a Threadripper monster with 4 Tesla V100 or Quadro RTX 8000 GPUs? Yes you can, but you cannot run macOS on it. And that's the whole point. So, from previous chapter about CPU performance, you know, it's impossible to build a Hackintosh which would have higher CPU performance than the 28-core 2019 Mac Pro for less money. And now again, you cannot build a Hackintosh which would have higher GPU performance than the Mac Pro equipped with two Radeon Pro Vega 2 Duo GPUs. Another strong reason why you cannot compete with 2019 Mac Pro is the ability to buy the Apple Afterburner card, which cannot be used anywhere else than in the 2019 Mac Pro. You cannot connect it to any other Mac via external Thunderbolt enclosure. You cannot connect it to Hackintosh. It would simply not work. So for big production houses, where their workflow is whole ProRes based, as I have, they can use even the base cheapest 8-core Mac Pro with one, two or three of these Apple Afterburner cards, and it would kick ass of any supercharged PC even running on Linux. So again, in Hackintosh, this is absolutely impossible. So let's move further to another chapter, and that's connectivity. 2019 Mac Pro offers on the motherboard 8 PCI Express slots, and what's important, 4 of these slots are double wide slots. That means you can in theory connect, for example, 4 dual slot GPUs or other devices, but still have another 4 PCI Express slots free for connecting additional cards. You cannot get this on any PC motherboard. It's simply, again, impossible. Close to it you can get, for example, again using the Supermicro motherboard I mentioned earlier, with just 7 PCI Express slots. But if you will look at the layout, all slots are single slot wide next to each other. So when you would connect 4 GPUs, those would block all the rest empty slots. On 2019 Mac Pro, you can get up to 12 Thunderbolt 3 ports. Show me a single PC which would offer this to you. So again, impossible. When using two Radeon Pro Vega 2 MPX modules, you can connect up to 12 4K displays using Thunderbolt 3 or 4 6K Pro displays XDRs. Can you do this on your dream Hackintosh? No, again, it's impossible. I can continue further, but I think now you have already a very good idea about it. So, when I will not count aesthetics, silence and overall quality of the 2019 Mac Pro, because if I would, then it would be absolutely clear you cannot get even close to it by building a Hackintosh. Then the overall result of an idea to build a Hackintosh which would beat the 2019 Mac Pro would be absolute fail and mission impossible. Only when you will start sacrificing some of your demands on CPU or GPU performance or connectivity, then you could build, for example, 16-core AMD Ryzen 3950X Hackintosh, which could work quite fine, but overall with less performance which 2019 Mac Pro can offer, despite for a higher price. 3950X Hackintosh could in CPU performance beat the 16-core Mac Pro a bit, but only in CPU-related tasks. But as I said on the beginning, any Mac is not just about performance of a single component. It's about overall performance. Whole macOS is greatly tied up to specific components and overall they work together. So at the end, only what matters on which machine you will get your job done faster. So now, I'd like to know your opinions, your ideas, what exactly you mean or expect when you shout for 2019 Mac Pro Killer Hackintosh. I will very closely listen to your comments under this video and then I will build some monster which could compete with the 2019 Apple Mac Pro in some areas. But as I explained in this video, it's impossible to build a Hackintosh which would beat the 2019 Mac Pro in all areas, and absolutely not for less money. So I'm waiting for your comments under this video. Maybe your comment will contain the winning idea of my next monster build. So, I hope I made your day again a little better, despite I think a lot of people in Hackintosh community are pissed off now from hearing the truth. But still, if you liked my point of view, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button and share this video with your friends so it can help to more people. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it and choose all notifications so you won't miss any of my future videos. You can also join my website morgonaut.cloud, so you will always have access to all my videos, tutorials and posts, or even to my personal individual help. Morgonaut is always here to help. And of course, don't forget to watch my other videos. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Macintosh and Hackintosh friends. Maybe already buy a video about super duper Wonder Monster Machine.